We use SLOs and error budgets to set appropriate reliability targets for our services. But what happens when there's an issue? We need to set up alerting to let us know that users are unhappy. Today, I'm going to show you how to use error budget burn rate alerts in service monitoring. This is the Stack Doctor. We've covered using threshold-based alerting before, but alerting on SLOs is a bit different. The main thing to keep in mind is that we want our alert to fire long before our service is out of SLO, essentially as soon as we start burning error budget. To start, let's cover some math. To help us, let's review Chapter 5 of the SRE workbook called Alerting on SLOs. If you haven't read it before, no worries, we'll link to it in the episode notes below. As covered in that chapter, your alerting strategy should include four considerations. They are precision, what fraction of your alerts are actually triggered by a real or significant event. Recall, what fraction of your events results in an alert. Detection time, how long does it take for an alert to fire once an event starts. And reset time, how long after the event is over does it take for your alert to reset. There's no right values for these considerations, so it all depends on what you want out of alerts. However, you'll probably want to find the right balance for you while minimizing your operational load. That is the number of alerts you actually receive and have to respond to. The best way to do this is by alerting on error budget burn rate, which is where the math comes in. Error budget burn rate is a measure of how fast, relative to your SLO, your service consumes error budget. For example, a service that has exactly zero budget left at the end of the SLO evaluation period has a burn rate of 1. A service that consumes all of its error budget halfway through the evaluation period has a burn rate of 2, and so on. We calculate our burn rate by looking at three main inputs: the SLO and its evaluation period, the amount of error budget consumed or burned, and the window over which that burn happens. That's the alerting window. This then is the equation we'll use to calculate burn rate that we'll use when we configure our error budget burn alerts. Our burn rate is the amount of error budget consumed by the service, multiplied by the SLO evaluation period, and divided by the alerting window. Okay, that was a lot. If you're a bit lost at this point, that's totally okay. All you really need to understand is that we can calculate the error budget burn rate if we know what our SLO is and how much of our error budget we want to consume and over what time before firing our alert. The next question you might have is, well, how much error budget should my service burn before firing an alert? Here, we again return to the Alerting on SLOs chapter of the SRE workbook for two simple recommendations. They are 2% of error budget in 1 hour and 5% of error budget in 6 hours. This way, you can both catch higher error rates quickly and lower error rates over time without overwhelming the on-callers with alerts. Let's walk through a specific example. Let's say our service has an availability SLO of 95% over a rolling 28-day window, and we want to create an alert that lets us know if we've consumed 2% of our error budget in the last hour. We use our simple equation to calculate the burn rate we need to hit, which is 13.44. Let's use the same equation to calculate the burn rate threshold for our other alert, 5% of error budget in 6 hours. This time, our rate is 5.6. Okay, so far we've covered error budget burn rates and how to calculate them. We're now ready to set up our alerts. Here's our service with our SLO configured against it. We're going to create an alert that lets us know when the service consumes 2% of its error budget in an hour. This is where error budget burn rate becomes important. To configure the alert, we need to specify the lookback window. In our case, it's 60 minutes. We also need to specify the burn rate we expect to hit during the window as our threshold. Remember, we'd already calculated that to be 13.44. Now, when our service has an issue, we'll see the error budget decrease, and we'll get an alert that looks like this, showing us the error budget burn during the incident. Thanks for joining me today. We covered a lot. We learned about the considerations that should go into your alerting strategies and why alerting on error budget burn is a great way to balance them against operational overload. We then figured out how to calculate error budget burn rates and saw how to use them to set up alerting for your services and service monitoring. Thanks so much for watching. Come back soon for more. This is the Stack Doctor. Stay healthy out there.